Okay, moi, ça qu'à la fois, pour les pays, à maman, mal la fille. Ou qu'à la fois, qui m'a quoi? Maman, qui m'a ma quoi? Oinga, ou qu'à quoi, ou assias. Ou qu'à la fois, pour la fin, on a pas eu à la quoi? Ils sont pas fait qu'à l'homme. Ou qu'à la fois, qu'il faut, et qu'à la moua, pour se via. La sunga, les nids pour les aunga, pour se fier, pour. Ou sui, qu'à qu'à y'a aunga. Y'a aïnga, faut y'a aunga. Ai mai so kamu ma kenga lo mua ngai. A fio mai ma kala mai au, I ka ko eno price kiwi, o le ngai ka sanga lo afte lo spu. Pa kai le lo fo le pua, a wasa le mau ki ngoa pe whaki ngo inga le mei whamoi moi. O ngali ai ka kua kumu mai a inga le whamai. Ai whas kai lo ngarofa, o ia kai kai mai ai lo koso I pua maso mako ola. Leo ka ku filo ai le ngai aso, Ka ko ki pak pakia ko fai ngā walo mwha ngā ole ngai la mua. Lea velo leo whaka o vāe fai masuiru sunga ni pule aunga, ma le ngai la mua. Ma ko ki whaka alofa, ki wha whelo ia. Ma alore so I fua mau ma langi ma.
Kia talo falava, malo ni, Māori, mingalaba, and warm Pacific greetings to you all. My name is Mariae Lutui, and I have the pleasure of being your MC for tonight. Tonight, we celebrate Bishop Viard's College's annual prize giving. We will witness excellence in a variety of areas. We reflect on the highlights of 2020. We also acknowledge the leadership shown in 2020 and the new leadership of 2021. We will start off this evening acknowledging God and the Thanksgiving liturgy for our students, whānau, and staff. Before we do that, we offer a warm welcome to our invited guests, Deacon Danny Karatea Goddard, Father Andrew Antonio and fellow priests, Sister Anne Phipps, Vicar of Education Jenny Gordon, Helena Bardwick, our statutory manager, Chris Wells from the Ministry of Education, local councillor Mike Duncan, Joshua Be'awafi, Aosanga Fa'asalele Tanuvasa, Margaret Highland, Gail and Officer Tael, and our Board of Trustees. And of course, a warm Viard welcome to our parents and whānau. We appreciate your support for tonight. Just a few housekeeping. In the event of an emergency, please follow the directions of our staff. If there is an earthquake, please drop, cover, and hold. Our assembly point will be the basketball court to my left. Bathroom facilities are located just outside the hall doors, men's to my left and ladies to my right. We will also be selling yearbooks for a cost of $15 from our main office. Please see Lucia after our prize giving. And remember to have a great evening. Thank you.
Thank you. Se keunga sili ona matango fie I le fatu o le tangata o le anganga whaafitai. E mumua lava ona o fatu la watu le pa ia whaatafa whao le tatu maota. E tumutumu fo I le anganga vivii ma le anganga whaafitai ona o le alofa me le anga lelei o lo tatu watua. A wā o lea ua tatu fasila fai I le maunga o ao. Ai le o le maunga o liu lau mea, I le soifua, o na whapea I lea se taofia tole a foa, ma lo le soifua manuia, ma lo le langi e mamā, susu mai, ma liu mai, a fio mai. Tato ifo matatalo, let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen.
A reading from the book of Ephesians. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything to stand, stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God.
Psalms 121. I lift my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore.
Our response is, Whakarongo mai ra kia mato.
For the church, that as we respond to the call to missionary discipleship, we bring comfort to those burdened by difficult situations, speak tenderly to all who are downcast, and strive for peace where there is aggression.
E te ariki, whakarongo mai ra kia mātou.
For young people, that in all that you do, they will be attentive to the word of God, discerning and promoting what is true, noble, right, pure, lovely, excellent, or praiseworthy.
E te ariki, whakarongo mai ra kia mātou.
For an end to the COVID-19 pandemic, that the efforts of scientists to find a vaccine be successful and that people show care for one another by following health guidelines. For all our prize winners, that your spirit of acceptance and gratitude be always at the forefront of their minds and pride shown by our whole school community.
Please stand, and can we say this prayer all together? Our final blessing. God of wisdom, we thank you all for the gifts you've given us throughout this school year. We praise you for giving us life, for saving us from Christ, and for choosing us to be your people. As we come to the end of this school year, we pray that you will We voice our gratitude for the good things you have done in us, and we praise you for all you have shared in the work of the school. We ask you. Praise you, God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you very much to our band. That was a lovely performance. We will now ask Mr. Setofano, Mr. Kanipping, Mr. Fausil to present our first awards. Presenting these awards will be Sister Anne.
Our prize giving this evening will look a little different from previous years. Not just the wonderful opening that we have experienced, but also how our students come up to receive awards. We have been over this with our junior students and will repeat some key messages for our seniors. So when your name is called, please stand immediately and show your pride. Come directly to the stage, coming up the middle here, not on the side like we used to do. We have also changed the way that we'll be taking photos of students and their trophies. So we will not take photos straight after the student receives the award. Every student that is awarded a trophy is required to, and any other students and their families or their whānau, via the whā doors, and you go towards Mr. Theobald's office and you can get your photo taken there. But that will be at the end. So as this is our first prize giving like this, I'll give you constant reminders throughout the night. So, onto our awards. The Diligence Awards for Year 7 and 8. Anaru Siohane Hune 7SF Diligence. So please stand and come to the... Thank you, Anaru. O Royal Leota. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, do you mind just holding your clap till the end of my speech? Thank you. O Royal Leota, Reishana Tautu, this overall diligence in Year 7 trophy. Navali Maladina, Year 8 FL for diligence. Sara Inmei Bawi, Year 8 SF Diligence, and Matalena Yosefa, Overall Diligence in Year 8 Trophy. Thank you. Well done to you beautiful children. Keep working hard. And you just thank you. The next award is Diligence Award for Year 9. Isabella Cardona Correa, Female Diligence 9B. Giovanni Yeremia, Male Diligence in 9V. Punipuao Allen, Female Diligence in 9V, and the Xavier Trophy for the most diligent female in Year 9. And finally, Dominic Dayanhirang, Male Diligence for 9B, and the Xavier Trophy for most diligent male in Year 9. Diligence Awards Year 10. Zardinia Sutherland, Female Diligence 10B. Daniel Yates, Male Diligence 10V. Henry Yates, Male Diligence 10V. Monica Mong, Female Diligence 10V. And the Avila Trophy for Most Diligent Female in Year 10. And finally, Jeremiah Frost, Male Diligence 10B, and the Avila Trophy for the most diligent male of Year 10. Alo, Congratulations, children. Moving on to the Diligence Awards. One more round of applause, please. The Diligence Awards for Year 11, 12, and 13. First up is Nerei, Year 11, Most Diligent Male. Leidia, Year 11, Most Diligent Female. And Year 11, Diligence Trophy for Most Diligent Student in Year 11. Ana Marie Tavita, Year 11, Most Diligent Female. And Year 11, Diligence Trophy for Most Diligent Student in Year 11. Oliver Tirotoru, Year 12, Most Diligent Male. Faye Nafatali, Year 12, Most Diligent Female, and the Joseph Frederick Hicks Cup for Most Diligent Year 12. Daphne Dayanhirang, Year 12, Most Diligent Female, and the Joseph Frederick Hicks Cup for Most Diligent Year 12. And finally, Mariae Ulutui, Year 13, Most Diligent Female, and the Year 13 Diligence Trophy for the Most Diligent Student. We are very proud of all these students, and I know you are as well. At this point in time, speaker. Okay. Give these beautiful people a round of applause, please.
In line with our recent senior girls' dinner, where our theme was We Are More Than Enough, our guest speaker tonight is someone who is from our own community and is an ex-Fijian student. We can look for inspiration from New Zealand representatives or the latest sport heroes, or we can look for our own inspiration in the people around us. I will now invite Mr. Theobald to introduce and interview our new guest, Mr. Nick Malley.
Kia ora tātou. I'll address you all later on, but I'm glad to see so many of our whānau joining us tonight. Nick Malley was a student at Bishop Viard College from 2001 to 2006, and during that time he enjoyed meeting new friends and being in an environment that challenged and excited him. After leaving Bishop Viard, he did a number of different jobs, mostly in the trade industries. But it wasn't until more recently that Nick started to go back to his passion of art. He knew that he could influence others and have an impact on the people around him through using his God-given talent. However, traditional media forms and styles were too constrictive to Nick. Not to be deterred, he created his own genre and style of art. He is now being commissioned to do personalized pieces of art for people around Porirua, New Zealand, and also globally. Nick is able to capture the essence of people that he draws and has been able to contribute greatly to many families through his art. We have also commissioned Nick to do a few pieces, and you would have walked past those on your way in this evening. We're just going to watch a quick video showcasing some of Nick's work, and then we'll invite him up.
escaping the desert. Guide yourself to open up. Now it's like you reach the sun. And escaping the desert. Now you breathe into the sun.
Okay, so instead of doing asking Nick to do a speech, although he really wanted one, we thought we'd just ask him a few questions, to a bit of an interview. So so we'll get started. So just loosening you up for the audience here, Nick, what's your favorite memory of Bishop Viard College?
Probably leading the first 15 out at Beard Trophy. Nah, it never happened, sorry. It'll probably be my first year at Viard, Sports Day. All the students here will know, if you're a young student and you're coming to do sports in front of, seniors, it's kind of scary. So I decided to do the 800, 400 meter, one of those, because, I can run. But as I was running, I got tired after the first 20 seconds and, everyone was passing me and then I heard someone else coming up and I thought, all right, just go pass again. But he stayed with me and I was wondering why they weren't going. And I just heard a voice say, hey, how you doing? Keep going, just keep going. I look back, and it was a senior, I don't know if he's here, John Schwager, just pushing me along. Back then, I thought that was embarrassing, but now I think it's kind of motivating,
Yeah, no, it's a great memory, and it definitely something that I saw this year for our sports day, where our head boy was just dressed up as Spartacus or something similar. And next to him was one of our year sevens carrying his shield. So a little bit similar. Now, obviously, you've had a bit of a career change and you've decided to follow your passion. So what was it that made you give up on some of those other roles and start to follow your passion?
There are a lot of things, really. At the end, it's really... if you've got a talent, why waste it? You don't want to be that servant that hides his talent, doesn't invest, and gives it back with nothing, So.
Nice, very good. Good biblical reference as well.
You like that?
Yeah, that was good. Sister Anne is nodding happily. It's very good. And so what are the barriers that you face? Because it was a bit of a risk to put yourself out there. What are the barriers that when you do... put yourself out there and show your talents. What are some of the barriers that you've faced?
Good question. I don't know. For me, I think it's time management. Having work and then kids and work again is trying to fit the art in to put out. But I guess if you really want to do it, you got to invest the time, lose some sleep, study hard, kids.
Yeah, lose some Facebook or Instagram time as well, possibly. So what's your favorite? You've done lots of bits of art all over the world now. What's your favorite piece that's meant a special something for you?
Probably doing a personalized piece for Dwayne The Rock. Jokes. I don't know. I'll probably, but, yeah, you shake it up here. For my partner, my partner's dad. I did an old photo of hers that she had that she wanted to renew, and yeah, just kind of, I saw the emotion firsthand giving the piece, so that was good.
And that's definitely what we've heard as well, is the emotion that your art creates. This piece that Nick was talking about was an old photo, just a 3x5 photo. That was the only photo that Katie's dad had of him and his father. And his father had passed away, and so Nick was able to bring that piece to life and bring a family together as part of that. Does that aspect of reigniting and bringing people to life and bringing people together motivate you?
Yeah, of course. It being, you know, visual art, you know, that's the purpose. You know, you want people to look at it and kind of give a good reaction, I guess. And yeah, so when it has emotional ties to it, it's good. You know, it's a good feeling.
And speaking to a few different people that have commissioned Nick to do different pieces, and that's exactly what has happened. And I know that the legacy of Nick's work will live longer than what he might be aware of, and because it is bringing families closer together, it's celebrating people that are very special. And it's wonderful that you're using your talents. It's wonderful that you've stood up in front of us today and shared that. And so can we just offer Nick a big round of applause. Thank you.
Thank you, Nick Malley and Mr. Theobald. We'll now call up Ms. Liao Pepe Tuala and Mr. Griffiths for our Junior Academic Awards from year 7 to 10, and also a big thank you to Mr. Setafano.
Thank you. The main reason why we're here is our academics. Can I hear an amen? Amen. All right. So we're going to start off with academic excellence in year 7. Anaru Siohane Hune. First in digital technology, first in religious education. Jack McCulloch Childs, first in design technology. Zacadius Schroger, first in mathematics. Selina Lokeni, Library Reading Excellence Award. Saimoni Tipa Levana Tambua, first in music. Pula to Saimoni. Reshana Tautu, Library Top Reader Award, first in art, first in English. Paki paki mai. But I have beautiful teachers as well, if you didn't know that. Academic Excellence Year 8, Navali Maladina, first in digital technology, first in art, the Michelle Dixon Cup. Chantal Faremo, first in mathematics, the Roos Cup. Claire May, first in English. Kimmy Zen Dolden, Library Reading Excellence Award and first in religious education. Yes. Matalena Yosefa, Library Top Reader Award. And Painalosi Simo, first in music. Academic Excellence Year 9, Punipuao Allen, first in music, Joseph Hreng Sa, first in physical education, Kilefongi. Amelia Dens, Library Reading Excellence Award, Emmanuel Attuck, Library Top Reader Award, and 9 BVAC Gold Awards. And finally, Troy Yolden, first in arts. Academic excellence for Year 9 continued. These are still Year 9 students. Matthew Dodds, first in food technology. Tiale Peter Jacopo Simiti, first in English. Isabella Cardona Correa, first in design technology. And Dominic Dayanhirang, first in science, mathematics, religious education, social studies, digital technology, and 9 BVAC Gold Awards. Beautiful students, well done. Moving on to our academic excellence for Year 10. Alia Faletutulu, first in 10 BVAC Gold Awards. Monica Maung, first in art, the BVC Art Trophy, and the Library Top Reader Award. Kieran Burney, first in food technology and 10 BVAC Gold Awards. Henry Yates, first in music, mathematics, and the Paris Patelicio Memorial Cup, and 10 BVAC Gold Awards. Robert Head, first in physical education. Zardinia Sutherland, first in mathematics, in the Paris Patelicio Memorial Cup, Social Studies and Design Technology. Jeremiah Frost, first in English, the Shepherd Cup, Digital Design, the Leader Trophy, and 10 BVAC Gold Awards. And finally, Daniel Yates, first in physical education, religious education, the Gail Thane Trophy, Science, the Max Zuga Trophy, Library Reading Excellence Award, and Te Reo Māori.
Thank you, Mr. Stefano, and congratulations to all our junior award winners. So our student leadership team was like no other before us at Bishop Viard. We were gifted the office right next to our principal. We were challenged to help define the new direction of our college and much more. We have looked at the legacy that we could leave the college and also the legacy that others have left before us. This is why we have suggested to our principal, Mr. Theobald, that we have an honors board to recognize the contribution to our college that all our deputy head students have made over the years. We have invited all our ex-deputy head students to our prize giving tonight, and I invite all of them to the stage now to unveil our new honors board. Please come forward and stand to the left of the stage. Can all our ex-deputy head boys and girls please come to the stage? I now ask our 2020 head students to present the honors board. On behalf of the current Deputy Head Students here at Bishop Viard, it is an honor to have our names amongst many great leaders of our past. We will now ask Jenry Sati, Deputy Head of 2003, to unveil the Honours Board. Thank you, everyone. We will proceed with our Senior Academic Awards. We invite back to the stage Mr. Sitofano, and helping to present these awards will be our Senior Whānau Leader, Nick Darling. Mr. Nick Darling.
Our Academic Excellence for Year 11. Wendy Dawn Faramo, first in Level 1 Food Technology and 100 plus credits. Lei Dia, first in Level 1 Visual Arts. Winter Ta'ape, first in Level 1 English and Economics. Aniva Tuiatua Papua, Level 1 Library Top Reader Award. Tane Burney, first in Level 1 Mathematics. Miracle Brown Va'atiwola, first in Level 1 History, the Freedom Cup, and NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 1. Serafina Joseph, first in Level 1 Science, Sports Studies, and 100 plus credits. And finally, Lesina Tawalei, first in Level 1 Design, Technology, Music, Religious Education, 100 plus credits, and NCEA Merit Endorsement Level 1. Academic Excellence Year 11, Ravi Pratap, First in Level 1 Digital Technology, the Leader Smith Trophy, Tane Rameka, Level 1 Library Reading Excellence Award, Siobhan Vauliko, 100 plus credits, John Jeffrey Latu Whangasoaia, First in Level 1 Geography, Toe Lokeni, NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 1, Roman Senil, NCEA Merit in Level 1, Merit Endorsement, Ocean Matete Stalin, 100 plus credits, and Manfred Sofara, First in Level 1 Samoan and NCEA Excellence Endorsement in Level 1. Well done, students. Academic Excellence Year 12. Asei Mong, First in Level 2 Digital Technology, Library Top Reader Award and NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 2. Chevy Willow Morrell, First in Level 2 Physics and NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 2. Ian Ngawalofa, 100 plus credits. Patrick Knox, 100 plus credits. Matarena Biri, First in Level 2 Tourism and NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 2. Malanga Aukusotino, First in Level 2 Pathways and NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 2. And Daphne Dayangirang, First in Level 2 Visual Arts, the Fitzgerald Rizzati Memorial Trophy, the English BVC Cup, 100 plus credits, and NCEA Excellence Endorsement in Level 2. Year 12 Academic Excellence continued. Fa'amanuia Paulo, NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 2. Albert Leray, First in Level 2 Design Technology. Emelita Leota, First in Level 2 Chemistry. Tanawat Michael, 100 plus credits. Dallas Marie Tone, 100 plus credits. And NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 2. Maya Aroha Kini, Library Reading Excellence Award. And finally, Faye Nafatali, First in Level 2 Geography, History, the Margaret Buist Cup, Religious Education, Mathematics, Biology, Samoan, and NCEA Excellence Endorsement in Level 2. Academic Excellence Year 12 continued. Samantha Patu, First in Level 2 Economics, the Commerce Cup. Laumua Tamalamani, First in Level 2 Social Sciences, Food Technology, the Hospitality Cup, and NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 2. Siose Lookeni, 100 plus credits and NCEA Excellence Endorsement in Level 2. Sione Makasini, 100 plus credits. And Oliver Toru Turul, First in Level 2 Sports Studies, Music, 100 plus credits and NCEA Excellence Endorsement in Level 2. Academic Excellence Year 13, Michaela Paul, First in Level 3 Digital Technology, the Leader Trophy, Mathematics with Calculus, tourism, and 100 plus credits. San Benedito, first in level 3 Gateway Trophy. Daniel Cortez Guerrero, Library Reading Excellence Award. Sakita Kingsada, NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 3. Doris Sitama Tupuola, first in Level 3 Visual Arts and the Oliva Onelino Memorial Cup. Elenisi Paper, first in Level 3 Food Technology, the Larson Trophy. And finally, Maria'e Ulutui, first in Level 3 Mathematics with Statistics, Religious Education, Geography, the Kevin Luck Cup, History, there's a cup for that, the Samoan Cup, 100 plus credits and NCEA Excellence Endorsement in Level 3. Academic Excellence Year 13 continued. Cheyenne Welch Olson, first in Level 3 Social Science and NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 3. Joshua Yates, first in Level 3 Sports Studies. Faith Teofilo, NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 3. And Hope Teofilo, NCEA Merit Endorsement in Level 3. Fortino Sofara, Library Top Reader Award. Fase'e Tamalamani, NCEA Excellence Endorsement in Level 3. Ezra Tomasi, first in Level 3 Music. And finally, Agnes Valassi, first in Level 3 English, Chemistry, Biology, Physics, Mathematics, the Knipping Cup, and NCEA Excellence Endorsement in Level 3. The next part of our program belongs to Maria'e, but she's busy taking all her trophies.
Now we'll just have a little break, and our band will be performing with our lovely singers that you saw before.
privilege to have a wonderful, strong Pacific woman leading our board of trustees.
Please put your hands together as I invite Lainey Longwoo to address us now. Tēnā koutou katoa, talofa lava, malo ni, kia rana, malo elelei, pakalofa lahi atu, Māori, Bula, Mingalaba, buenas noches, and a warm welcome to all our blessed and distinguished guests, our amazing students, and their wonderful families. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I am honoured to stand here tonight to help celebrate the united achievements of our students and their families. I say united because it is a team effort that has brought each recipient to this event tonight. A team which consists not only of the student, but their support network of the school, and more importantly, the support network of their family. To the students receiving their awards tonight, please remember to be thankful for the blessings from God you have received and the sacrifices that have been made for you. The challenges that 2020 presented resulted in the physical, mental, and spiritual growth of each and every person here in this hall tonight. I have seen fortitude and the unity of Bishop Viard students, staff and families determined not to let the effects of COVID-19 be an excuse to throw the towel in and give up. I have seen faith in our sports teams facing their toughest rivals. Our senior volleyball girls have chanced that combat lost points. Shake it off, reset, go again. It is the chance to pick up the fallen player, regather, and restart. I have seen service to honour our families when many of our students came together to practice and proudly showcase their many and other cultures via the online Fia Fia night. I have seen dignity in the many students wearing their correct uniform with pride, being punctual to school and making good choices each day. All things are possible when we work together. As an ex-Viardian, it warms my heart to see the spirit of Bishop Viard College once again growing and spreading throughout the college and the community. Now I'd like to acknowledge one of our former student trustees who is a leader tonight, Faye Nafatali, who held her position over a couple of years. I would like to thank you, Faye, for your dedication and contribution to this role. Once again, thank you all for the support you have given your children and our school. We will continue to collaborate with Chris Theobald and his team of 40 to strive for better academic achievement. To our Year 13 students and others who are leaving, may God continue to bless you in your future endeavours. Congratulations to all our recipients and enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you. Thank you very much, Lainey. I now invite back to the stage Mr. Setefano, Mr. Kniping, Ms. LaFalcelle to join our chair with the Sports and Contribution Awards.
Sports awards. I have three awards to give out this evening. The first one is service to sports at Bishop Viard College. This young person is involved in a lot of sports this year, athletics, basketball, 3x3 basketball, volleyball, table tennis, futsal, rugby, and e-sports. It gives me great pleasure to announce service to sports at Bishop Viard College to Joshua Yates. Senior Sportswoman of the Year. This young woman was involved in basketball, badminton, athletics, football, volleyball, college sports awards. It gives me great pleasure to announce the Senior Sportswoman of the Year for 2020 to Emilita Leota. This fine young man is a true sportsman. He was involved in athletics, volleyball, table tennis, tag, and rugby. It gives me great pleasure to announce the Senior Sportsman of the Year to Siose Lokeni. Plays rugby the way I used to play rugby back in the day when I was here. Well done. Right, we're going to carry on to contribution and endeavour awards. To Matthew Dodds, the Library Service Award, to Tane Burney, Technical Team Service Award, Zacadius Schroger, the Merv West Memorial Trophy for contribution to Spirit in Year 7 and 8. Seth Cohen Nu'uausala, the Kevin Swain Memorial Shield for contribution to Spirit Year 9 and 10. And Punipuao Allen, the Thorburn Cup for contribution to music by a junior student. Contribution and Endeavour Awards. Aries Adam, the Technical Team Service Award. Oliver Tirotoru, the Thorburn Cup for contribution to music by a senior student. Fortino Sofara, the Parents and Friends Cup for contribution to the spirit of the school. Fa'ase'e Tamalamani, the Assumptionist Father's Shield for contribution to liturgy. To Maria'e Ulutui, the Porirua Council Citizenship Award. To Heidi Juliana Fajardo Songamoso, the Endeavour Award, and to Vania Reedy, the Endeavour Award, and Renee Ngarima, the St. Michael's Award, recognition of exceptional endeavour.
Can we give one more round of applause to our last? Thank you. So this year of 2020, I've been a leader myself, and I have been fortunate enough to work alongside an inspirational leader, our head girl. Please put your hands together as she gives her last address on behalf of the student leaders and students in general, our head girl for 2020, Agnes Velasi.
Talofalava, Maluelele, Kia ora, Mingalaba, and warm greetings to you all. For the last time this year, I am proud to say that my name is Agnes Valasi, head girl of Bishop Baird College for 2020. And what an honor it has been to serve this school. When the opportunity to speak at prize giving was brought to my attention, I struggled with identifying the type of message I wanted to convey. After all, this would be the last time I would have the privilege of standing on the stage to address our school community. And after much deliberation, I decided to dedicate my speech to the tall poppies. The tall poppy syndrome, for those that don't know, is a cultural phenomenon. It is the expectation that all poppies should grow together at the same time to the same height. Thus, when a poppy grows taller than the others, it is cut down to size in order to fit the image and standards of a perfect poppy. In today's modern society, it describes the behavior that those who are high achievers and stand out are criticized by those around them for not fitting in. I am a tall poppy. And although I say this with confidence now, it actually took a long time to become unapologetically me. My journey to become the tall poppy I am today started in 2014. I know it's very long ago for some of you. It was my first year at VR, okay? I remember one moment vividly in my mind, and it was during a tour of the school prior to the first day. I was led around the hall, and as we were walking out, I stopped at the plaques at the back of the hall that named all the past student leaders. And I just remember thinking as I gazed up, I want to be one of them. Scratch that. I will be one of them, and my name will be on that board. That day I made a promise to myself, and this was the start of my growth. At the time, however, I didn't understand why I chose that particular goal, nor did I understand the pilgrimage I was signing myself up for. It was only last year that I truly figured out my why, my reason for wanting the leadership role I hold today. Within the past 7 years that I have wandered through these hallways, from my very first day here at Viard to this exact moment, I have been gifted with experiences I believe would not have been possible outside of the school. You see, Bishop Baird College is more than a typical educational institution. For me and many other students, Bishop Baird College is our home. It has witnessed my darkest moments as well as my highest achievements, wiping away my tears to the pain and celebrating alongside me in joy. But when I first started at Viard, I never understood just how important it would be. I never realized the people I was starting my intermediate and college journey with would become a strong village of brothers and sisters. Nor did I realize that my teachers who educated me in their specialized subjects would also educate me in life and provide a guiding light through the dark. Through trial and error, panicking about assessments, navigating through friendships, and finding my own identity, I realized that Viard truly has something special. It has the potential to become a true influence on our community and fellow colleges. All of these experiences deepened my understanding of what Bishop Viard College stood for, and what followed was the epiphany of my why. To give back to the community that has given me a home, a family, and an unforgettable experience. In the end, Viard constructed an unwavering foundation on which I grew into a strong and tall poppy, capable of achieving many goals, one of which is this leadership role, the very one I promised myself to aim for 7 years ago. And although this may seem like a happy ending, it doesn't exclude the fact that my journey required a lot of hard work and the determination to face many hardships, challenges, and fears along the way. My journey has taught me that fear only exists to be overcome and is created to motivate personal growth. After all, there is no such thing as perfection, only progress. And for our students, if you're paying attention in daily assembly, you would know that I did say this before. So despite being scared, I decided to face my fears head on. And through dedication and hard work, I persevered through the obstacles that stood in my way. I overcame those who thought I couldn't make it, as well as the moments where I myself became my own worst enemy and resented the gifts and talents that made me stand out. It was through facing those that wanted to cut me down that I grew even taller. The apex of my growth occurred during this unorthodox year of 2020. And man, what a year it has been. Many trials and tribulations have occurred this year, and despite how it may have panned out, together we have managed to remain the strong family we pride ourselves in being. Sports Day was our first event of the year, which brought people together from across all year levels. But COVID struck soon after and brought forth a time of uncertainty. However, it also brought to light an opportunity to support each other during such a difficult period. In order to create more opportunities for our students, we have held boys, girls, and fa'avai dinners that uplifted our students. And finally, Fia Fia Night, which despite setbacks and changes, was an unforgettable night that solidified the bonds between us. This year has been one giant curveball, but I wouldn't have it any other way. And now it is time to pass on the torch. To the students of Bishop Viard College, and in particular, the future student leaders, I can confidently say that at some point in our lives, we have all felt like a tall poppy, like someone who stood out too much in a society that failed to recognize our individuality. But understand that this is not a disadvantage. Our experiences, talents, and values will always set us apart from others. And it is through these differences that we are able to grow in understanding and compassion for one another. So make the effort to understand your why, your reason for waking up every morning, for coming to school, for striving to excellence. Then work hard and stay determined to achieve your goals with your why guiding you through. And in this way, you will stand proud as a tall poppy that not even the sharpest shears can cut down. I have completed my journey here at Viard, taking with me the values of this college through to the next chapter of my life. And I am only able to stand before you all today as a proud, confident Samoan young woman I am now, because of these significant people who have lovingly placed a stone onto my strong foundation. So before I leave the stage, I'd like to thank my teachers for always having high expectations of me and pushing me to achieve great things. Thank you to the Filippo family and the Kelemete family for making me one of your own and providing me with a home, a family, and so much more. To my aunties and uncles from both my Balasi side, especially Uncle Kulua, and my Vuiola side, particularly my grandma, who continue to support me constantly and remain proud of my endeavors. To Charlotte, for taking me under your wing and helping me overcome obstacles in my life, thank you. My girls, specifically Alicia, Se'e, and Jackie, thank you for being there with me to make crazy memories with. And to my families, especially my mom, thank you for always believing in me, having my best interests at heart, being my rock, and for being my buddy. Without any of these people, I wouldn't be who I am today, and I am honored to be here tonight as proof of their love, support, and faith in me. Whaftai te le lava, and God bless.
Thank you. Malole ngosai. Please just turn to your neighbor and rub their shoulder. The one in front of you and the one behind you. All right, thank you. Overall Academic Excellence Awards. Reshana Tautu, Year 7 overall academic excellence. The Nellie Hunt Memorial Trophy. Chantal Faremo, Year 8 overall academic excellence. Moya Cup. Dominic Dayangirang, Year 9 overall academic excellence, Bishop Viard College Trophy. Henry Yates, Year 10 overall academic excellence, Bishop Viard College Trophy. Manfred Sofara, Year 11, overall academic excellence, Bishop Viard College Trophy, and the Nellie Hunt Award for Samoan Oratory. Faye Nafatali, Year 12, overall academic excellence, Bishop Viard College Trophy. Sakita Kingsada, Academic Improvement in the Senior School, the Frost Cup. Lanice Ramika, Senior Māori Female Student, Academic Excellence, Three Baskets of Knowledge. And Joshua Yates, Senior Male, Māori Male Award. Thank you. Thank you. I would now like to invite Mr. Joshua Peawafi to the stage to present. National Excellence Award. The Hustle. The following students, as members of the Hustle Business Venture, gained a National Academic Excellence Award for regional and then were national award winners of Yes Business Enterprise in the category of Social Impact Award. Can I invite to the front, please, the Hustle, Fa'amanuia Paulo, Leofi Ili, Maya Aroha Kini, Oliver Tyrell Turo, Siose Lokeni, and Le Latu, and Malanga Aukustino. Malanga is also acknowledged for his role as the CEO of The Hustle, for which he was awarded a regional award winner for Wellington CEO and was a finalist for the National CEO of 2020. Thank you very much. Now we come to the National Excellence Awards and Scholarships. What do you call a boat full of academics? A scholarship. Thank you. So the first one is Sakia La. I invite the Vicar of Education, Jenny Gordon, to the stage, please, to present the first of our awards, the Archbishop's Award for Catholic Leadership, and it's awarded to Sakia La. Right. Our deepest apologies from Sakia. We thank you very much, Jenny Gordon. Paki paki, please. I would now like to invite a rep from Victoria University of Wellington, either Dr. Sue here, or Ausanga Tanuvasa. So this next scholarship is in honour of Dr. Jenny Neal, a highly respected teacher, supervisor, and mentor at Victoria University. Dr. Jenny Neal was a strong advocate for female achievement, particularly young Māori and Pasifika researchers. The scholarship will assist the winner with her studies at Victoria University, and the recipient is Sakida Kingsada. Thank you. Another round of applause, please. The next award is the Prime Minister's Vocational Excellence Award, and this scholarship is to assist a student to continue with further studies in a chosen career pathway and acknowledges outstanding effort and achievement in the trades program, available in partnership with tertiary providers. The recipient is Albert Leray. The Wellington North Rotary Scholarship for Perseverance and Academic Achievement is for Tino Sofara. The Otago University Pacific Peoples Entrance Scholarship. The Otago University scholarships are awarded to students with a very high standard of NCEA achievement and will assist them to study at Otago University. Two students met the high standard to receive this scholarship, and they are Fa'ase'e Tamalamani and Agnes Valasi. I would now like to invite to the stage Margaret from Victoria University, Gail and Ofisa, please. Te Herenga Waka Scholarship. The Wellington Te Herenga Waka Scholarships were established this year by Te Herenga Waka Victoria University of Wellington through philanthropic funds. They are aimed at growing the participation and success of Māori and Pasifika students and those from refugee and low socioeconomic backgrounds in Decile 1 to Decile 3 schools in Wellington. They are focused on supporting students who have shown resilience through adversity and determination in achieving their academic and personal goals. A Wellington Te Herenga Waka scholarship covers full accommodation costs in a Victoria University of Wellington catered hall of residence for the first year of study, course fees, and contribution to course-related and living costs throughout the recipient's undergraduate degree program. Scholarships have an impact well beyond the financial support and demonstrate to a young person that somebody not only cares about them, but believes in them and has confidence in their ability to succeed. The university will also provide a comprehensive wraparound support package through a structured and intentional programming featuring personalised advising, academic mentoring, mentors, internships, leadership and community service opportunities. The value of the Wellington Te Herenga Waka Scholarship is $50,000. Paki paki for that, please. And the inaugural recipient of this scholarship from Bishop Viard College is Maria'e Ulutua. Maria'e intends to study a conjoint Bachelor of Laws and Bachelor of Arts in Criminology at Victoria University of Wellington in 2021.
He hono re he kroria ki te atua. He ngā mana, he ngā reo, he ngā iwi. He rau rangatira mā nao mai hare mai piki mai. Tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa. Kia ora hui hui mai tātou katoa. Tārofu lava, whaftai tele lava mo le awanoa ia whaamanuia le atua le tātou laungatongi. Kia ora ana, mā lo ni, mā lo ilalei, minga la ba, o la, bula, me auri. 2020, whoa, it's been a remarkable year, and it will be easy to reflect on this year's negative events, but for me there have been far more successes than failures, far more achievements than disappointments, far more pride in and for our college. So while I will not minimise the massive disruptions to people's lives that have occurred this year and the loss that many have faced, I choose to focus on the strength and resilience that I have witnessed from our students and their whānau in the face of adversity. At Bishop Viard College, we have strived to be a little bit better each and every day. We have raised expectations of students, whānau and staff. We have moved on from our Day Zero event of October 2019 and now stand before our community as a college on the rise. We do go on about uniform a bit too much, but please let me digress for just a moment. I am proud to say that our students wear the uniform with pride. This simple yet daily ritual isn't actually about the clothing that we wear. It is about taking personal responsibility and managing ourselves. It is about being aware that we are but one part of the whole, one part of something much bigger than ourselves. And we are continuing a legacy of greatness when we fulfill our potential and follow our purpose. This is why we powerfully say, we are Viard. Just going to watch a very quick clip of our year, and I'll continue my kōrero in just a moment.
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh. Second thing, second, don't you tell me what you think that I can be. I'm the one at the sail, I'm the master of my sea. Oh, ooh, the master of my sea. Oh, from a young age, taking my soul into the masses, writing my poems for the few that look at me, took to me, shook at me, feeling me, singing from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the.
So say a happy Easter.
Hey, you made me up, you made me up, believer. Dove, oh, ooh, your spirit up above, oh,
in the clown, falling like ashes to the ground. Hoping my feelings, they would drown, but they never did, ever lived. Ebbing and flowing, inhibited, limited, till it broke up when it rained down. It rained down like
you made me a believer.
See, it's been a pretty busy year, and we couldn't have got here by ourselves. We've got a few acknowledgements. Our Board of Trustees have grown a great deal this year. They volunteer their time and their energy to help ensure that our college is on the right path in serving our students and serving our community. A very special thank you to Lainey Laumoa, our Board Chair, who has very quietly at times and humbly led us and displayed at all times a servant leadership where she has nothing but the best interests of our college at heart. Thanks also to our statutory manager, Helena Barwick, for expertise and dedication to ensure that our college builds a solid foundation. We have a small gift for Helena. Thank you to our two deputy principals, Gina LaFalcio and Stephen Knipping, both of whom have given many, many hours and much sacrifice to our students and college. They are both very skilled at what they do, and we are fortunate to have them at our college. I also acknowledge our business manager, Peter Knipping, who is a big part of the successful development of our college. Our staff have had some large changes this year. We have many new faces that have joined our VR team, and each new face has brought their own vitality and passion. Having such a large amount of new staff can be hard on existing staff members. However, our experienced staff members have opened up their hearts and their minds to our new staff. This is testament to our existing staff members' passion that they have for the college and our students. I give my sincere thank you to all of our staff who have helped us start to deliver the education that our students deserve. Tonight, we farewell Ture Thompson and Michelle Brunt, two staff members who have been dedicated to our college for many years. Matua Ture has been a staff member for over a decade, and just after lockdown, he left us to head to Rotorua. Unfortunately, because of the COVID, we didn't get a chance to farewell him. Matua Ture has led our Māori department in Te Ao Māori at Bishop Viard College with grace and humility. We thank Matua Ture for his many achievements and the many students that have been moulded by his hard work. Michelle Brunt has led our social studies department since 2011. We are very sad to see Michelle go, as we know her smiling presence is such an asset to the staff. Michelle truly cares about each and every one of her students. A message to our whānau and community, including those guests gathered here tonight. Your commitment to our college does not go unnoticed. Turning up tonight does not go unnoticed. We thank you. At Bishop Viard College, we have started to enrol families, not students. And we appreciate all families fronting up and supporting their sons and daughters and our college as a whole. To our students, you have proven in quite a remarkable year that each and every one of you are indeed quite remarkable yourselves, including our MC of this evening, Maria'e Ulutui. And so we have a small gift for Maria'e. All of our students, you have tenacity and fortitude. You have passion, and many of you are uncovering your purpose. As a college, we are proud of you. We believe in you and know that we love each and every one of you. To our Year 13 students who are leaving us tonight, one message that has been ever present in our college is that the gift is given and to hand it on. And so as this day dawns when you'll wear your red blazer for the last time, the gift that you can give to our current students and our future students is to be your best and give of your best to the community and to yourselves. And so for our Year 13 students, life won't always be easy. But as Agnes referred to, don't be afraid to stand out. Don't be afraid to be that tall poppy. And don't be afraid to work hard for what you want. We have exciting plans for 2021 and beyond. I encourage you to support and uplift one another as we seek our Lord's support, as we create something truly wonderful within these walls of our beloved college. I'm now going to move on to present our 2020 Supreme Awards. These awards are the top awards in our college and awards that every student should be striving towards. The first award is the Nellie Hunt Spirit of Excellence Award. The Nellie Hunt Spirit of Excellence Award acknowledges students who have shown excellence in up to three areas: leadership, sport, and academic. This year, it is jointly awarded to Fuatino Sofara and Faasee Tamalamani. Fuatino has shown excellence in leadership through her involvement in Poly Club and the Fia Fia Night, and in service through her frequent support and willingness to assist in school events. Fuatino has shown excellence in her academic achievement. She gained 87 credits in level 1, 76 in level 2, and already has 80 credits in level 3 and is on track to gain a merit endorsement. Faasee has shown excellence in leadership through involvement as leader of the Faith Pillar and in service through her frequent support and willingness to assist at school events. Faasee has shown excellence in her academic achievement also. She has gained 105 credits in level 1, 115 in level 2, 84 credits so far in level 3, and has gained an excellence endorsement at level 3. Our Nellie Hunt Award winners. The Proxima Accessit has been an outstanding model of academic excellence in her time here as a student of Bishop Viard College. This student gained 112 credits at level 1 with an overall merit endorsement. She gained a subject merit endorsement in geography and subject excellence endorsement in religious education. This student gained 98 credits in level 2 with an overall merit endorsement, and again gained subject merit endorsement in geography and excellent endorsement in religious education. This student has gained 107 credits at level 3 so far, with 73 at excellence level. We await the final subject endorsement results to be confirmed in January. The Proxima Accessit for Bishop Viard College 2020 is Mariae Ulutui. The Ducks. This student has been an outstanding model of academic excellence in her time at Bishop Viard College. She has gained 128 credits in level 1, with 106 of these being at excellence. While in year 11, she studied level 2 maths and gained subject merit endorsement in English, subject excellence endorsement in art, geography, religious education, and science. The student gained 114 credits in level 2, with 85 of these at excellence level. The student studied mathematics with calculus while a year 12 student and gained subject merit endorsement in English, chemistry, and subject excellence endorsements in biology, physics, and religious studies. This student has gained 99 credits so far at level 3, with 85 being at excellence level, earning her already an excellence endorsement for NCA level 3. As Ducks of Bishop VI College, this student is also offered an Otago University Ducks Scholarship. The Ducks for Bishop VI College 2020 is Agnes. One final aspect of our prize giving, which is where we look towards 2021 and announce our student leaders for next year. I would like to invite this year's student leaders to the stage one last time to pass on the mantle of leadership. Our faith leader, Fa'asee Tamalamani. Our fortitude leader, Cheyenne Welsh Olsen. Our dignity leader, Maria'e Ulutui. Our service leader, Samuel Nelly. Our head boy, Joshua Yates. And our head girl, Agnes Varasi. This group of students have been challenged to not fit into the mould that has gone before, but to step outside, and they have done a truly remarkable job at forging a new way forward for our college, and I thank them all very, very much. Choosing our deputy and head students for 2021 was a remarkably hard task, but I'll just get on with it. Our faith pillar leader and deputy head student is Malanga Okasotino. Our fortitude academic pillar leader is Laumua Tamalamani. Our dignity pillar leader for culture is Matarena Biri. And our service pillar leader for sport and music is Oliver Tyrell Toru. Our head girl for 2021 is Faye Nafatali. And our head boy for 2021 is Siose Lokeri. to our new head students of 2021, the impression that you leave on this college will be entirely up to you. So make of this opportunity as much as you possibly can. I'll ask our students just to stay here for one more moment as I finish my kōrero and our event this evening. Just a very quick reminder, students that have received trophies, we're going to ask you to leave this door and circle round and get a very quick photo in front of my office. Whānau and students, if you want to go and take a photo with your students, you're more than welcome, but you have to leave this door, please. Also, the yearbooks are at the office for $15. I'm going to finish my brief speech with a small verse from Matthew 25. For I was hungry and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you invited me in. I needed clothes and you clothed me. I was sick and you looked after me. I was in prison and you came to visit me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you? Or when did we see you thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you in a stranger and invite you in or clothe you if you needed clothes? When did we see you sick or in prison and visit you? And Jesus will reply, truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me. So as we venture on towards Christmas, as our year 13 students leave us to take a confident step into their futures, as we all look forward to a break, as we wish each other a Merry Christmas, I ask you to see the Lord and those around you, to choose love over fear, and to uplift people emotionally, spiritually, and physically. Because that is what we do here at Bishop VR College. That is who we are.
We are VR. Nō reira, nāmuhi mui kia koutou. God bless.